Some people might find it quite surprising to know that Apple's smart home platform, called HomeKit, works really very well with Home Assistant. In fact, Apple's Home app on iOS is actually the main way that I control most of my smart home devices. Let me show you how it all fits together. When we talk about integrating Home Assistant with HomeKit, there are actually two totally different types of integration. It's important that you know which one you are trying to set up before you begin, or you might be disappointed by the results. If you want to be able to control the devices and entities that you've got in Home Assistant already from the Apple Home app or Siri on your iPhone or iPad, then what you need is the HomeKit integration. But if you want to add an Apple HomeKit compatible device to Home Assistant, so as Home Assistant can control, monitor or automate it, then you need the HomeKit controller integration. There's a growing number of HomeKit compatible devices on the market, and it's quite useful to be able to pair them directly with Home Assistant instead of your iPhone, so as you can control them from solutions that they might not otherwise work with, such as Android phones or Alexa. I'm going to show you both of these in this video, starting with just the main HomeKit integration. The very first thing you need to do is make sure that you can edit your configuration.yaml file. If you're running the supervised version of Home Assistant, that's the one with the add-on store, then the easiest way to do this is to install the file editor add-on. You can see I've got it installed here and it appears on my left-hand menu bar. So when I click on it, this is what I'm shown. You need to find configuration.yaml. So if you click there, locate configuration.yaml, you'll see it's already loaded for me here. Now you need to paste in a bit of configuration to activate the HomeKit integration. I've already got it here. I'm going to copy and paste this into my configuration YAML file and click on save. Let's go over this line by line. So the first line here is just a name that you're going to give this. This name will appear when you connect it to the home app in iOS. Next thing to configure is the port. Now I suggest you start at 51828. The reason you have to specify the port is that you can have multiple instances of this integration running. Let's say for example you wanted to share some devices with your phone, but your children, you just wanted to give them access to the devices in their own bedrooms. You can run a separate instance of this multiple times, each with different ports. Now, by default, this integration will share every single compatible device straight from Home Assistant into Home. What I think is a sensible idea to do is actually set a filter so as it only shares certain devices. There's a limit of 150 devices in Home at the moment, I think, and you can hit that limit quite quickly. So to keep the mess down in the app, I suggest you just share specific devices, and you do that by using this include entities option and then listing all of the devices underneath. And the final thing I want to show you is how you'd customize one of those entities. Let's say, for example, that this switch here had a name that you didn't want to use in the Home app itself. What you can do is customize it here and tell it the actual name you'd like to use. Anyway, once you've pasted that configuration in and made sure you've saved it, you need to reboot Home Assistant. You go to Developer Tools, just click on Check Configuration to make sure it's all good, and then the restart button and restart again. Once it's restarted, you should see a little notification down here. If I click on notifications, you'll see this nice HomeKit pairing section. Now what I'm going to do now is open up the Home app on my iPhone, click on continue, and then I'll need to tap add accessory. Now I've got to scan that QR code right there. There we go, you saw that. I'll tap add to Apple Home. It's an uncertified accessory, so I've got to add it anyway after that warning. It's going to ask me for a bridge location. I prefer to go to create new room and continue, and I create a new room called Home Assistant, which is going to be like a default location for where the Home Assistant entities will start appearing. There's the name that's being passed through, test HA bridge. I click on continue. and it's all added. Now what it's going to do next is cycle through all of the accessories that are in that list and ask me to confirm that I want to add them and where I'd like to add them. So that was my study light, so I'm going to create a new room called study and I'm going to add it to there. Click on continue. My aero garden switch is also in my study. Going to add that there. I'm going to display it as a switch, but you could say it's a fan or a light if you wanted to. And then I've got this test helper switch. I'm going to put that in Home Assistant, the default room, because it's just a test. Click on continue. It's just a switch. Let's pretend it's a light today. And continue. And then I've got my living room thermostat, so I'm going to add that to the living room. There we go, and done. Just to demonstrate how reactive this is, you should see this test switch here on the Home Assistant dashboard. If I open it in the Home app, I can turn it on and off pretty quickly. Let's say you wanted to add another device to this. All you need to do is go back to your file editor and find your configuration. You go down to here and type in what was the other one I'd planned, ensuite blind. Yeah, that's it. So I'm going to copy and paste that into the list here, save it. Now you don't actually need to reboot this. All you need to do is go to developer tools, scroll down to where it says HomeKit under YAML configuration reloading and click on HomeKit. If I give it a few seconds to update itself and then open the Home app, you'll see that the ensuite blind has now appeared in that list and I should be able to tap it to close it. You can see it's closing itself there. So now let's look at the HomeKit controller integration. I've got two HomeKit compatible devices. One is a Netatmo weather station, and that's well and truly integrated into Home Assistant right now. The other is a Roku smart TV stick, and I've not actually added that to Home Assistant yet, so it's available for me to test. So this is going to be a bit of an experimental demo as well, because I have no idea whether this will work, but I'm going to use it as a demo, so hopefully it will. Let's go and have a look. So in theory, what should happen is you'll see a notification pop up in Home Assistant once you turn on the Roku. And if I now go down to notifications, new devices discovered, and I should see, here it is, Roku discovered HomeKit controller. So let's click on configure. Taking a while. Right, an unhandled error occurred. Okay. I have to go into the menu, down to settings, and then I can go down to Apple AirPlay and HomeKit. It'll load this little application. I go down to HomeKit setup, and it gives me a code. So I'm going to type that code in now. Submit. Now it wants the pairing code again, I guess. 9186 9828. Done. Let's go see what we've got. I've absolutely no idea what sort of controls this exposes to Home Assistant, so I'm as eager to find out as probably anyone here watching, if anyone's watching. Anyone there? We've got one device and one control. I'm going to add that to the dashboard so we can see what we're doing. Yep. Overview. So it's a standard media control, really. So if I go and find a video to play, just put some live TV on. The world's most dangerous roads on Dave. Let's see what that's like.
If your car has seen better days, visit Car Finance 24/7. If your car has done you proud, it's time.
Turn that volume down. I should be able to pause it. I can pause and play. It's not giving me any media information, but you know, You should use the actual proper Roku integration if you want to get all that sort of detail, I think. This is just a demo to show you how the Roku would work, but it could be a temperature sensor, it could be a water monitor, it could be, what else do they do? I think you can even get like water control valves that are HomeKit only. You can get pretty much anything now, really, all HomeKit compatible. If it won't work with Home Assistant natively, you can add it using the HomeKit controller automation. HomeKit controller integration. There you go, two different ways of using HomeKit with Home Assistant. I hope you found this useful, and if you did, then please give this video a like, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more videos from me. Thank you for watching, goodbye. Thank you.